Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we're going to cover the top 10 new features in HitFilm version 16. Number one, voiceover audio can now be recorded directly in HitFilm through either the media panel or the file menu. So for example, file, record, voiceover. It now brings up a box that will allow you to start the recording at any time you like. Simply click on this and it gives you a countdown, and then you can start actually recording your voice. When you're done, then you hit this again and it immediately adds this WAV file directly underneath your original audio and video file, as well as in the media bin. Number two, there is a new remove unused command that deletes all unused assets from the media panel with a single command. All you have to do is right-click in the media panel and select remove unused, and it will remove any asset that is not currently being used in your project. This is great for cleaning things up when you're done. Number three, editor tracks can now be renamed by simply double-clicking on the track name. So before, you had to right-click and then say rename track to get this little box. Now all you have to do is just double-click on it, and you can type in your new name and click OK, and it's super simple and easy to do. Number four, there is now a command to remove all empty tracks on the editor timeline at once. All you have to do is right-click and say delete empty tracks, and it will immediately delete any and all empty tracks in your editor timeline. Again, very easy to do and will make cleanup of your project when you're finished a real breeze. Number five, now there is an option to sync video and audio tracks when scrolling vertically through the editor timeline. So right now, if I just scroll vertically through the video or through the audio timeline, they are separate. But what if you wanted those to be synced? Well, this right here, this icon, sync scrolling, if I click on that, now as I scroll, they are both scrolling together so that the video 2 and audio 2, video 3 and audio 3 are in line, in sync with each other so that I can work with those tracks individually. Number six, there is now added support for decoding of H.265 video files in HitFilm. This is super important because more and more cell phones and drones and cameras are using this codec, so it's nice to be able to drop that right into HitFilm and be able to use it immediately. Number seven, export frame functionality has been extensively reworked with more options and greater control. Used to be that the export frame was here in this drop-down menu. It has now been moved to export with the other export features and options available to you. And if you click on frame, then you will get a menu where you can select the folder that you want to put the file in. You can see what the file name is going to be. You can select whether you want that to overwrite a previous file that has been named there. You can change the format of it to whatever format you like. And you can choose whether you want to not re-import it into the project file itself. You want to re-import it into the media bin. You want to re-import it into the timeline. Or you want it to re-import into the timeline as a single frame. When you have done that, then you click OK, and boom, it immediately brings it in here as a picture file that you can use right here in the timeline itself. Number eight, a pro-only effect. The new motion lock effect allows effects to be applied directly to a video layer and be tracked to the movement within that video. This is how that works. Let's say I take this video clip and drop it into its own composite shot, has a little bit of movement going on. I come down here to the video cleanup folder and find the motion lock effect, drag it on here. It immediately analyzes the footage first, and then after I start playing this, you can see that it is, in effect, keeping it steady. If I like where it's at, I can select certain motion points if I want. But as soon as I like it, I will click Apply Transform. And now you can see that it is moving, but the whole thing moves as if it is locked into place. So now I can go ahead and add a different effect. Let me, for example, add a bonfire effect and drop it right here. And let me just put that bonfire effect maybe right there on that spot and parent it to there. Now you will see that that bonfire effect stays in that spot even though the camera is moving around. Again, this is a pro-only effect, but it could really come in handy for very quickly applying effects and different things right into your footage. Number 9, pro-only effect. New custom light flares effect introduces over 60 new presets and a new interface for building your own custom flares. Let's say, for example, I have this lighthouse picture here and I want to add a flare. Then I would add a new plane and click OK. And if I search in the lights and flares, custom light flares, and I drag this onto the plane, you can see right away that it is a very slick looking light flare. If I were to click on options, then you can see all of these various preset light flares. So for example, you might go with an alien light flare. Oh, look at that. You might go with an anamorphic enterprise flare or whatever. There are over 60 of them. In this case, I think I want to go with lighthouse fog and click apply, and you can see that. Now, if I just take the opacity and I take that down a little bit so that there's a little bit of a fog there, and then I place that directly there over the lighthouse, all of a sudden I have changed that to look completely different. There are so many choices to choose from. It's incredible. And you can literally build your own light flares directly here in HitFilm and save them as your personal presets. And number 10, now GLTF model formats are supported for importing 3D models and animations. Those 3D models also support physical-based rendering PBR and use both the metallic roughness as well as the specular glossiness materials. I went to Sketchfab and I just randomly searched for a spaceship and I found this spaceship, which has some pretty nice little metallic glossiness to it. I then proceeded to download the auto convert format, the GLTF, right here, and then I brought it into HitFilm. I dropped this into a scene real quickly, and I played this, and look at how lovely that is. Just beautiful, and that is literally right out of the box. I didn't even change anything. I haven't even played around with the different material options that are available to me. I just dropped this directly in, and look at how awesome that is. So this is perhaps the most exciting thing in HitFilm 16. By the way, I left a link to the URL for that model. If you want to go play with that yourself, feel free. It's in the description. If you enjoyed this video, do me a favor and like it and subscribe to the channel and click the little bell icon for notifications. If you have any questions about HitFilm 16, definitely leave them in the comments below. I'll be happy to answer those for you. Otherwise, thanks for watching.